Start PS1, PS2, we need to understand quantozoom. So, photosynthesis and quantozoom. What is mean by quantozoom? So, quantozoom, collection of pigments which are involved in photosynthesis. Those pigments, they are involved in the process of photosynthesis. That pigments collection is known as a quantozoom. It means, what are the pigments that are involved in the photosynthesis, that pigments totally collectively known as quantozoom. In quantozoom mainly, chlorophyll A is a reaction center chlorophyll. So, chlorophyll A is called reaction center chlorophyll. So, chlorophyll A is a reaction center chlorophyll because the process of photosynthesis will start from chlorophyll A. Next, remaining pigments means remaining chlorophylls, carotenoids and xanthophylls, they are called accessory pigments. Chlorophyll A is a reaction center chlorophyll, it is a main chlorophyll. The process of photosynthesis will be starts from the reaction center chlorophyll A. Remaining pigments like remaining chlorophylls, carotenoids and phycobilins, they are generally calling it as accessory pigments or helping pigments. So, this is the chlorophyll A, reaction center chlorophyll A. Next, these are the accessory pigments. These are accessory pigments. Accessory pigments. Generally, wavelength or sunlight will falls on this photosystem. This sunlight is called photons. Sunlight energy is known as photons. So, sunlight have in sun rays, in the wavelength of light, energy is there, that energy is called photons. These photons or sunlight falls on this reaction center chlorophyll and as well as accessory pigments. So, this is reaction center chlorophyll. These are accessory pigments. Reaction center chlorophyll is a middle, remaining are accessory pigments. So, chlorophyll A absorb their particular nanometers of length. Accessory pigments also, they will absorb their respective wavelength of light. So, chlorophyll A will take their respective sunlight, respective wavelength of light. Remaining accessory pigments also, they will absorb their respective sunlight, respective wavelength of light. And chlorophyll A is generally will take the energy from remaining accessory pigments. So, will take the sunlight, then after this energy is absorbed in these accessory pigments. Accessory pigments send this photons to or energy to next pigment to finally reaches to reaction center chlorophyll. Same like that. This one also send the energy to next pigment to reaction center chlorophyll. Same like that. Energy transfer to next pigment to chlorophyll A. Same. One pigment energy travel to next pigment to finally reaches to reaction center chlorophyll, that is A. So, accessory pigment, they are absorb wavelength of light, that energy will shifted finally reaches to these particular chlorophyll A. Chlorophyll A absorb remaining pigments of wavelength. It means total energy finally transfer to chlorophyll A. Chlorophyll A is immediately activate and release two electrons Chlorophyll A is excited because heavy amount of the energy is there. That's why two electrons are released by chlorophyll A. Next, these electrons, they are received by primary electron acceptor, which is primary electron acceptor. Those electrons, pair of electrons received by primary electron acceptor. It is normal situations in laboratory conditions. So before that, this reaction center chlorophyll and accessory pigments to make up the reaction center chlorophyll and accessory pigments, both are make up, that is antenna complex. Reaction center chlorophyll, accessory pigments, both are collectively to formation of antenna complex. So this is general conditions, general situations. If chlorophyll A is isolated or extracted, so chlorophyll A is isolated or separated, from the these accessory pigments, what will happen? This chlorophyll A absorb photons, it means their respective of light. Next, chlorophyll A, it is activated by the photons. Next, chlorophyll A release chlorophyll A excited and release two electrons. That electrons received by actually primary electron acceptor, but in this laboratory conditions, in experimental conditions, in test tube, there is no primary electron acceptor. So that's why that electrons are again come back to reaction center chlorophyll A. It is higher energy, that is higher energy level. This is the lower energy level. So pair of electrons are travel from lower energy level to higher energy level. From the higher energy level, again these pair of electrons comebacks to chlorophyll A. This is laboratory conditions, because there is no primary electron acceptor here in test tube. That's why higher energy level to again will be tendency to back to lower energy level. Next, now we are discussing about photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Photosystem 1, Photosystem 2. In photosystem 1 and photosystem 2, the reaction center chlorophyll as usual A only. So reaction center chlorophyll A. Here also reaction center chlorophyll A. Next, chlorophyll A associated with accessory pigments. Same. Here also, chlorophyll A is a reaction center chlorophyll in PS2 also, nothing but photosystem 2 also. and chlorophyll A or reaction center chlorophyll associated with accessory pigments like remaining chlorophylls and what is that, phycobilins and carotenoids. Next, these what is that, sunlight or photons falls on photosystem 1, same photosystem 2 also. So these pigments, remaining pigments, send this energy to chlorophyll A. Here also remaining pigments are activated and send this energy to chlorophyll A. Chlorophyll A immediately activate and release pair of electrons to primary electron acceptor. So here also same, chlorophyll A release pair of electrons for primary electron acceptor. So pair of electrons are released by chlorophyll A, and pair of electrons are released by chlorophyll A in PS1 also as well, PS2 also as usual. So next, in this PS1, this reaction center chlorophyll and accessory pigments, both are make up what is that, antenna complex. So in PS1, chlorophyll A and accessory pigments, make up antenna complex. Next, so this chlorophyll A and accessory pigment to make up antenna complex, and light, how much wavelength of light is absorbed by photosystem 1? Photosystem 1 absorbs 700 nanometers of light. Next, here light is absorbed, same 683 nanometers of light is absorbed by photosystem 2. Here also antenna complex is formed, so 680 nanometers of light absorbed by photosystem 2, 700 nanometers of light absorbed by photosystem 1. And PS or photosystem 1, also known as PS1, here also PS2, simply we are written as photosystem 1 PS1, photosystem 2 PS2. Simply we are writing P700 and P680, we are simply, P700 means photosystem 1 absorbs 700 nanometers of light and PS2 absorbs 680 nanometers of light. So this is comparison of photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. In both situations same thing, what is that, reaction center chlorophyll A as usual, accessory pigments same as usual, their chlorophyll A excited by the photons, next release electrons, pair of electrons, are generally received by primary electron acceptor. Same here also, pair of electrons are taken by primary electron acceptor, same, but difference is only take up the wavelength, so photosystem 1, absorbs 700 nanometers of light, photosystem 2 absorbs 680 nanometers of light, that only we are observed in the time of photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Generally one thing, chlorophyll A is reaction center chlorophyll, there is no accessory pigments because chlorophyll A is isolated or extracted. Chlorophyll A excited by the photons, and release pair of electrons, not received by primary electron acceptor, that's why they will come back to chlorophyll A. That's why it is high energy level and this is low energy level. From the electrons are received to high energy level and high energy level sends to again reaction center chlorophyll A. So that pair of electrons again come back to what is that? Chlorophyll A. At the time some wavelength or some light is emitted, some light is released. That light is generally wavelength. Some color is released, the color of light. Some color is released. That color generally we are absorbed in chlorophyll A. Chlorophyll A emitted that color. So high energy level release two electrons. At the time of two electrons, some amount of wavelength of light is will comes out. It is comes out. So that light is generally absorbed in, that is a chlorophyll A. So that is some wavelength of light is emitted from the higher energy level. So this process is called fluorescence. Fluorescence means higher energy level again tends to send back to chlorophyll A. At the time of some wavelength of light is emitted, that light generally enters into chlorophyll A. We are absorbed at the time of chlorophyll A emitted that color. Then that wavelength of light releases. So that process is called fluorescence. Process is called fluorescence. In next video, we are talking about actual process of photosynthesis. So first thing, that is photophosphorylation. So we are discussing next chapter, next concept, that is photophosphorylation. So if you like this video, please like, share, comment, and for more videos, subscribe this channel.